All of you sit.
Last week, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, called for a meeting between the Uganda Human Rights Commission, leadership of opposition, and the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, to mend a way forward on unanswered questions of the opposition on the fate of missing persons and other issues of human rights violations. However, we have learned that the meeting that was to sit in the Speaker's boardroom hit a snag as the chairperson of the Uganda Human Rights Commission, Mariam Mwangadia, showed up without other commissioners as she was directed by Parliament.
The meeting did not take off. Well, as the chairperson came with the two technical staff, she did not come with her commissioners. From the communication, a copy of which I received from the Speaker, the invitation was for her and her commissioners so that Parliament can have an understanding of where her dilemma is.
Wangadia was sent back to mobilize a team of commissioners who are said to be upcountry, and they agreed to reschedule the meeting to a later date this week.
So the Speaker advised that the meeting be held on another date before the end of the week, and that she had given the commissioner, the chairperson and her team, time to go and consult their diaries before the end of the week and have the meeting rescheduled.
Addressing the press after the flopped meeting, Mpoga noted that Wangadia looked to be in a very difficult position as she was questioning the spirit of this meeting.
The chairperson of the commission sounded a bit beleaguered in being invited for such a meeting, but the Speaker assured her that the meeting is not just a meeting in good faith, but an exercise of the highest level of responsibility on our part, that we seek to give the country what people demand of us as their leaders.
Some opposition lawmakers have been made to believe that this ping pong is deliberately done to rout the quest for justice of victims of human rights violations.
These meetings won't come up, won't bring out any result. The only result we have got from our engagement and the effort Parliament has exhibited is to make the entire public know about how these market tricks are being planned and how they are being staged.
Meanwhile, the leader of opposition has welcomed sanctions imposed by the Commissioner General of Prisons, Johnson Bewashaija, saying it's an opportunity to hold all people involved in human rights violations accountable.
The lesson we learned from the sanctioning of the Commissioner General of Prisons is exercise of authority should be measured. Clearly, we have seen people coming out of prison with torture marks. The media has been awash with, especially last year, with torture victims. And they're being produced in court. And they have been in custody. And the question is, the police has not come out, or prisons have not come out to disown the torture, or to actually clearly state, spell out, who is responsible for the torture.
Mpoga also asked Ugandans wondering what new President Robert Kyagulanyi meant when he said some opposition MPs work for President Museveni to put the questions to the person responsible for the remarks.
Please wait for the president to have a press conference and ask him to explain what he meant. Probably it would be a good opportunity for you and the nation to know what exactly he meant.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.